Now, this video is what I call my 1-inch variable. This is the stumbling block in most magnetic motor designs. Most of these come within an inch of rotation, and they're just short of actually working. It's that 1-inch variable that most of us are dealing with. It's the roadblock we're all trying to overcome. This configuration is loosely based on some of Howard Johnson's design work, which you might be able to pick out if you look at how it's put together. I'm doing this particular video to demonstrate a problem that pops up in just about every rotary design that anybody does. Now, what this is doing, you line this up in the field, and the magnet will come around to within about an inch of where it needs to be. If you put it back in the field, same thing. That's the ironic thing about most of these rotary designs, is you'll come to within about an inch of where you need to be. Now, in this particular version, I've got a few neodymium magnets here, and there's a few on the other side. Without the neos, it pretty much just bounces around, doesn't do much of anything. The neos give it a little bit of forward momentum. I'm going to change the configuration around a little bit just to show you that different things don't really make a lot of difference in your configuration patterns. Now, this is roughly the way that I have the magnets configured right now. Now, obviously, this is the red meaning the north, the green the south. I've got the larger magnets facing this way, and the smaller magnets with the north pole facing out. On the rotor, I've got neo magnets, the south pole facing the stator, and the north pole facing out. Now, because of that, your directional rotation will be clockwise, because the south will always prefer the north, therefore it'll bounce past the repulsive force and go in this direction. Now, all you would need to do to set this up in repulsion mode would be to flip the magnets on the rotor, and you can change to the other direction. It's pretty simple. This is just a real basic, simple setup that's similar to what Howard Johnson did quite a bit. When you put the neos into the configuration, you want to cap the poles that the rotor is being attracted to. So your neos would be placed here. If you were working in repulsion mode, you'd want to flip these in the other direction. You'd pop them on this side instead. Now, the next obvious thing to test, of course, is adding more magnets to the rotor. A lot of people, when they have difficulty with just a couple magnets, they they say, oh, just add 2 or 3 more, that'll make the difference. Really what it does is it makes it worse. This makes it so you're not getting within an inch anymore. You're barely getting any movement at all, regardless of which direction you spin. So the next obvious thing to do would be to put neos all the way around, rather than just in certain placements. Okay. So once you get the neos all the way around and give that a test spin, you see that doesn't really help either. And again, it makes it seem like it's even worse. Now, here it is with the spin accelerators added to the back portion. And it's still no go. If you move the accelerators around, you will find that you can line this up in a way that it gets within an inch or two again. So, with everything that I've demonstrated so far, I'm still back at square one. This kind of work can literally make you want to pull your hair out. He started at this point right here, comes all the way around to this point, move it to the next point, and it goes all the way around. You literally come within an inch. It's amazing how, no matter how you change the configuration around, it always seems to come to within an inch. How ironic. Now this is the completed repulsion mode version. If you line this up here, it spins all the way around here. Move it up to there, and the same thing. So you literally get within maybe an inch, inch and a half of achieving rotation. Now what I did different in this version, I changed the magnets on the rotor so that they are in repulsion mode. I moved all these neodymium magnets so they're facing this way instead of the other way. All of the spin accelerators, I angled the back magnets to add to the directional rotation. And obviously it doesn't work, but it's interesting that however you arrange this, however you change it around, it usually comes within about an inch of rotation. Just like most magnetic motors, you go on YouTube and you analyze some of the different attempts that people have made, it usually comes to within that inch. Just fascinating. At some point, one of us is going to figure out how to break through that barrier. And that's really all that's holding us back.